Good evening, everyone. We'll call the board workshop to order. First item on the agenda is from the board president. I have no agenda items this evening. Next item on the agenda is from the superintendent.
Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Madam President. Tonight we have a split session with the report from the superintendent. We'll have the presentations from Armour, Bain, McCourty, and District Architects. Where is...
Way back there.
We'll do the regular report out here, and then we'll go with the executive session in the other pieces here.
Does anyone have any questions for Mr. Dana, who reviewed all of that over the weekend? Okay. That's it for now.
No, we'll do B. We'll do C, D, and E, and E.
Okay.
D is a resolution to approve facilities project change orders associated with approved projects. NFA renovation project, NFA auto body, and HOH renovation project, South Middle School renovations, GAMS renovation, and GAMS science renovation. Bill's Gate renovation, set one and set two, and Gardner Town renovation project.
Any questions on the change orders this evening?
There are no questions. There may be some changes in the resolution. We are currently finalizing our review of the abatement change orders that are listed for DSA and NFA. There are three change orders there. We're currently going through the process of evaluating the time sheets to make sure everything matches. I did want to get them on the resolution. And if they're not finalized, they can hold, or they could be modified to reflect our final negotiations. There are also two others that we're currently reviewing, and those would be Thomas Kenton on the second page. There are two credits, one for $33,000, which is the credit to change from the specified steam boilers to provide new hot water boilers, and also the credit for the base bid, which was a change from the Airedale units to put the rooftop units on. We're still evaluating those as well, so those could change, or they could be pulled and could be processed at a later date. Everything else has been reviewed and assumed on the final.
What do you think the probability that review will be done before Friday, so that could possibly any amendments could go to, home to the board in their Friday packet?
Whatever we're going to do will be done in time, so the final document will go out. I spoke with Eisenbach this afternoon. They're going to be finalizing their review tomorrow, so I'll have that information tomorrow. And I also have a meeting with the architect and the engineer to go through the two changes. So all will be done, wrapped up before Friday.
Great.
If we're not finalized, so this will be but we'll have a final change order resolution for approval next weekend.
Great. Yes, Mr. Whipple.
This was a function of the flood that we had, and this is work that the contractor needs to repair and paint. We have a cost code set up, and we will be evaluating whether or not there's going to be an ability to back charge contractors with regard to the flood.
Oh, okay. I was just saying, we shouldn't be paying something that we didn't.
No,
we didn't have it for ourselves.
It's something that the contractor needs to do the work. He needs to be reimbursed. We need to figure out if there's a vehicle for us to recover.
Mr. Woodrow, you might want to pull that mic over towards you. Some of the people can hear. Thank you.
And there can be some further clarification on that, Mr. Woodrow, in executive session.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions or comments on the change orders? Yes.
On the hands for the start of the mission, the live action, where your fire group will send it to the corridor, that's something that is at the state of use to start the mission.
That's the code issue we had. You may recall on the other side of the corridor, it was actually $35,000. It's where the classroom walls didn't run all the way to the deck. And when we took the ceilings down as part of the abatement process, this was done T&M, and we actually were able to bring this in for significantly less than the other side.
Yes,
it's a code really bad. It's a good question. But the narrative doesn't say that.
That's the end of my report.
Thank you, Mr. Kuzak. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Student Intervention and Support Services.
Thank you, Madam President. Mr. Swanson and I will present the items.
Madam President, I ask that the board consider the CSE recommendations for February 2012 as presented before you.
Questions? Yes, Mr. Levinson.
Mr. Swanson, it's listed that they conducted, in the last 6 months, I guess, 292 program reviews.
I'm sorry, where are you looking?
Number five.
Okay.
Conducted 292. These reviews of these students are classified, and what kind of services do they have?
They vary. Program reviews, program reviews are usually a significant change in the IEP or a parental request, such as a change of service, addition of service, reduction of service, things like modifications of goals, accommodations we usually do through an amendment and a meeting. Those would not be included here. So these are students for whom either their current setting is no longer, it is felt that the setting is no longer working and we need to change the setting, one way or the other, more restrictive environment, less restrictive environment. And of course, anytime a parent asks for a program review, we honor that. So it's a whole potpourri, I should say, of types of program reviews.
Okay, so but it's reviewing students with an existing IEP.
That is correct, yes. These students are already classified.
Do the bulk of them have one-on-ones or no?
I would have to go back and check, but I would say no, that one-on-one aides are usually not the most common reason for a program review, although some are. If you want to be more specific in terms of what the information you'd like, I can prepare that for next week's meeting. Would you like to know which of these reviews included a review of a one-to-one aid, either adding or deleting?
Yes, because of the low number of classified, that's why I want to see if we're going to be taking people away. The board voted to take people away, but we're not declassifying these students according to these numbers.
Right, a student does not need to be declassified to have a one-to-one aid removed. That is a support and service. Again, as we've talked several months, most declassifications occur in the month of June at the end of the school year. A student can still be classified as a student with a disability and have particular supports and services removed, such as a one-to-one aid. But I can certainly give you, you know, as detailed a background as I can for next week's meeting.
Thank you.
Sure.
Any other questions for Mr. Swanson? Okay, Dr. Reagan.
The next item, Madam President, is the facility use requests. There are 9 facility use requests in front of you. We discussed them today at the Buildings and Grounds Committee. The information is most of it in order. The only thing that's missing is on the first one, we need to find out how much the lights and sounds cost will be. The rest of the information is fine. What we are also going to do is ensure that on the second page and the third page where we are trying to approve the facilities for the town of Newburgh Recreation Department to ensure that if there are going to be construction projects or alarm enhancements, that they are aware of that and they don't interfere with the use of the facilities.
Don't you have an additional request that you presented at the Buildings and Grounds Committee today?
Yes, Madam President. There will be, and the update will include a facility use request that we received this afternoon on an emergency basis. We are trying to help an organization, and it will be for the use of Academy Field on March 31st for for a soccer game, and we are trying to help an organization that had already scheduled the field and it fell through for reasons that they were beyond their control. So we provide that info and the update.
Questions on the facilities use request?
Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Dr. Boyega. Thank you, Mr. Swanson. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction.
Thank you, Madam President. I have two items this evening. Sitting at your table, we have two resolutions for field trips. The first resolution is for an overnight field trip. The Newburgh Free Academy track team to compete in the 19th Global Challenge of Champions track meet in Mobile, Alabama from April 4th through the 8th, 2012.
Item B is a resolution to increase the 2011-2012 general fund budget using funds from a donation by the Windsor School PTO. They donated $5,404 for the purpose of installing a new swing set. It's been run through Buildings and Grounds. Item C is a resolution to declare equipment surplus obsolete and authorize its disposal.
Yes.
I'm not sure if I'm sure we have to see emails on their weekly status, and I'm wondering if we can manage that, or can we start taking advantage of that, where it's cell phone, or computers, whatever, it's free of charge.
Well, we actually try to sell them first, either Craigslist, eBay. We try to get something for them. If not, then we dispose of them. And I'll certainly look into that option.
Is there any talking about the whole cell phone, the internet, or the whole cell phone, drop them off, ship them out, and then the schools are making basically $100 a month on regular cartridges and cell phones and everything. I think maybe we should be investigating it.
I'll forward you the email, Mr. Sullivan.
Okay, thank you.
We've got a couple of questions.
Okay. Last item is resolution to accept the monthly building reports.
Yes, Mr. Levinstein.
Just two things on here. And based on the budget for this current year we're in, adjustments that were made, workers' comp, it was listed, the original budget was $341,000.
Correct.
And again, $1.1 million.
Right.
Is there, do we have a problem? Do we have something?
Well, it was decided by the board from 2010-2011 to lower the operating budget for workers' comp and for unemployment and for tax certiorari's and use the reserves as the backup. That's basically a planned fund balance use to keep the tax low.
Okay, but did we
We're anticipating paying that.
We self-insured for our workers' comp?
Correct.
Okay, and similar thing was then, I guess, your explanation for the unemployment that we added $800,000 to that.
Right. If, to make it correct based on the projections when we're doing the budget last year, similar to what you're going through now, the operating budget would have been higher by a couple $1 million, but the board decided to use the fund balance for this exact purpose, so that the taxes weren't raised at that particular time, and to start lowering the fund balance.
Resolution J is to approve appointments for the after school program Project Hope. The funding source is the McKinney-Vento Grant. Resolution K is to approve appointments for the 21st Century After School Program at Meadow Hill School. Funding source is the 21st Century Program Grant. Right. Resolution L is to approve the appointments for the Bonneville Sunrise Program. The funding source is Title I, Part A, the ALEC funds. Yes, Mr. Whipple.
I'd like to discuss this when we come to the session.
Resolution M is to approve the appointments for the Foster Town Early Riser Program. Funding source is Title I, Part A, the ALEC funds. Resolution N is to approve the appointments for the Title III Extended Day Program. Funding source is Title III, LEP. Resolution O is to abolish a full-time food service helper position and to create a full-time cook position. There's no effect on the general fund. Yes, Ms. Rich.
What's the purpose of that?
The school that this involves is just one of the larger schools, and Mr. Calvano requested that he needed additional help for a cook, and he could do without the food service helper. He needed the cook help more than that, so he asked the board to consider that and went with personnel.
Can we bring that up in executive session as well?
Yeah. And resolution P is for your information only. It's upcoming 10 recommendations for teachers. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Lyman. Board have anything else for the public portion of the workshop? Be it resolved that the board hereby recesses into executive session for the following purposes: to review the employment history of particular individuals and to discuss proposed acquisition, sale, or lease of real property securities only when publicity would substantially affect the value thereof. The board will not be taking action after the executive session.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you all for being here this evening. I'm sure we'll see all of you and a lot more on Thursday evening for our budget workshop. Should be here at 6 p.m. That the Board of Education public meeting will be held here in this location on Tuesday the 27th at 7 p.m.